آلهة لولا يأتون عليهم بسلطان بين فمن أظلم ممن افترى وإذ اعتزلتموهم وما يعبدون إلا الله فأووا إلى الكهف ينشر لكم ربكم من رحمته ويهيئ لكم من أمركم مرفقا وترى الشمس إذا طلعت تزاور عن كهفهم ذات اليمين وإذا غربت تقرضهم ذات الشمال وإذا غربت تقرضهم ذات الشمال وهم في فجوة منه ذلك من آيات الله من تجد له وليا مرشدا وتحسبهم أيقاظا وهم رقود ونقلبهم ذات اليمين وذات وكلبهم باسط ذراعيه بالوصيد لو اطلعت عليهم لوليت منهم فرارا ولملئت منهم رعبا وكذلك بعثناهم ليتساءلوا بينهم قال قائل منهم كم لبثتم قالوا لبثنا يوما أو بعض يوم قالوا ربكم أعلم بما لبثتم فبعثوا أحدكم بورقكم هذه إلى المدينة فلينظر أيها أزكى طعاما فليأتكم برزق منه وليتلقى يتلطف ولا يشعرن بكم أحدا إنهم إن يظهروا عليكم يرجموكم أو يعيدوكم في ملتهم ولن تفلحوا إذا أبدا وكذلك أعثرنا عليهم ليعلموا أن وعد الله حق وأن الساعة لا ريب فيها إذ يتنازعون بينهم أمرهم فقالوا ابنوا عليهم بنيانا ربهم أعلم بهم قال الذين غلبوا على أمرهم لنتخذن عليهم مسجدا سيقولون ثلاثة رابعهم كلبهم ويقولون خمسة سادسهم كلبهم رجما بالغيب ويقولون سبعة وثامنهم كلبهم ربي أعلم بعدتهم ما يعلمهم إلا قليل فلا تمار فيهم ولا تقولن لشيء إني فاعل ذلك غدا إلا أن يشاء إذا نسيت وقل عسى أن يهديني ربي لأقرب من هذا رشدا ولبثوا في كهفهم ثلاثمائة سنين وازدادوا تسعا قل الله أعلم بما لبثوا السماوات والأرض أبصر به وأسمع ما لهم وَاتْلُ مَا أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ كِتَابِ رَبِّكَ لَا مُبَدِّلَ لِكَلِمَاتِهِ وَلَنْ تَجِدَ مِنْ دُونِهِ مُلْتَحَدًا واصبر نفسك مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهه ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا واتبع هواه وكان أمره فرطا وقل الحق من ربكم فمن شاء فليؤمن ومن شاء فليكفر إنا أعتدنا للظالمين نارا أحاط بهم سرادقها وإن يستغيثوا يغاثوا بماء كالمهل يشوي الوجوه بئس الشراب وساءت مرتفقا صدق الله.
Sadaqa Allahu Mawlana al-Azim. Verily Almighty Allah speaks the truth. Jazakallah khair, shukran, and Bayt Ramakasi to Hafiz Hassan for that beautiful melodious rendition of the Quran. May Almighty Allah accept and may Allah bless us all through the barakah of the glorious Quran. Ameen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. My dearly beloved Jamaatul Muslimin, honorable elders, respected mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, and all our beautiful children, I greet you with the universal greetings of peace, love, and mercy. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad wa ashabi wa barik wa sallim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي بحق حبيبنا وسيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. Indeed, we begin in the name of Allah. Allah, our beloved Creator, the most gracious, the most merciful, the most forgiving. We believe as a Muslim that none is worthy of worship but Allah alone, and Allah has no partner whatsoever. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu, And as Muslims, we believe in all the prophets, and we bear witness to the fact that Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last, final, and true prophet of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. Almighty Allah says in the glorious Quran, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقَتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah says, for a surety, that Allah did not create His entire creation in vain. Every creation in heaven, on earth, in the sea, under the earth, under the mighty mountains, wherever there is creation, every creation serves a certain purpose. The purpose of all the creation that is known to us and unknown to us. And the world since the beginning has witnessed the most humongous dinosaurs at a certain period of time, to the smallest and the minutest insect that ever exists. And therefore today, we focus on the subject, the might of the tiny mosquito. We are not focusing even on the might that the dinosaur had, or the might of the elephant, or the mighty and great creation of Allah. We put our focus today on one of the tiniest insects that Allah has created, and that is the mosquito. And Allah Almighty makes mention of the mosquito in the Quran. In case someone might ask or think, why, what is the use of talking about the mosquito in the hour of Jum'ah? Let me remind you, Allah has thought it relevant, eternally relevant, to mention the mosquito in the Quran. And Allah says in Surah 2, which is Surah Baqarah, verse 26, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَحْيِي أَن يَضْرِبَ مَثَلًا مَا بَعُودَةً فَمَا فَوْقَهَا. Allah say, and Allah is not shy to make the parable of a mosquito. Allah is not shy about that. فَمَا فَوْقَهَا, and what is on top of the mosquito. Allah mentioned two things, the mosquito, and according to established science, there's another tinier insect than the mosquito that lives on the back of the mosquito and living off the mosquito. Where was this knowledge more than 1,500 years ago? No one knew this. It proves that this knowledge was given to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam directly from the creator of the universe himself. فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. Allah says, and verily those who believe and those who claim to have iman in their hearts, they know that is the truth, and this is the truth from your Lord Allah. وَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, and as for those who disbelieve in the signs and the ayat of Allah, فَيَقُولُونَ, they say, هَذَا مَاذَا أَرَادَ اللَّهُ بِهَذَا مَثَلًا. What does Allah mean by this parable, by this comparison? What does Allah mean by it? Why is it so important? The parable of the mosquito, Allah say, يُدِلُّ بِهِ كَثِيرًا. With this comparison, Allah say, يُدِلُّ بِهِ كَثِيرًا. It leads a lot of people astray because they don't want to take heed to the ayat of Allah. وَمَا يُدِلُّ وَكَثِيرًا وَكَثِيرًا وَيَهْدِي بِهِ كَثِيرًا. And a lot of people are guided aright by this parable that Allah mentions in the Quran. وَمَا يُدِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ. And Allah says, it is only the ignorant who are diverted from the truth, and they are the clear and open sinners. Allah called them fasiqeen, open sinners and rebellious against Allah Almighty. Do we know that scientists tell us, you know, when we look at the mosquito or we hear that buzz sound at night in the dark, zzz, we only think of one tiny insect, and that is the mosquito. Do you know, scientists say that there are 300 different species of mosquitoes. Allahu Akbar. 300 species of mosquito. And Allah makes mention of the species Ba'udatan. Allah refers to the female mosquito, because we know in every creation you have male and female. Here Allah speaks of the female mosquito. She is the one that bites us. She is the one that sucks our blood. Must be a she. It's not an attack against the women, eh? We admire and we salute our women. They are the queens of our homes. And Allah has chosen the woman to continue the process of creation. But Allah say, do you want to know which mosquito bites you at night? It is the ba'uda, it is the female mosquito. Bearing this in mind, this tiny insect, I want to take your focus to the time of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. In the time of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, lived one of the most evil people that the world has witnessed. Besides Fir'aun, who was also one of the most evil people, this person, his name was Nimrud. Nimrud was the king of Babylon in the time of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. It was this king Nimrud that built the tallest towers that the world has ever witnessed. The tallest towers. When he ascended that towers, on top of that tower, when he looked down, homes, palaces, buildings, even mountains looked very dwarfed and small in his eyesight. So massive and high these towers were. And why did he build this tower? Because he defied Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam that there is a God that exists which he termed in the sky. We know God Almighty is not in the sky. فَأَيْنَمَا تُوَلُّوا فَثَمَّ وَجَهُ اللَّهِ. Wherever you turn, there you find the presence of Allah. Allah is omnipresent. Allah is everywhere. People who believe that Allah is only in the sky, there's something seriously wrong with their thinking. So this Nimrud thought that this Allah lived in the sky, and therefore he built this mighty, tallest towers that history has ever seen in order to go and see if there is an Allah in the sky. But of course, he found nothing. And he came back and he said to Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, there is no such thing as an Allah. I didn't meet him in the sky. It is this very Nimrud who gathered his mighty army and he instructed them all to take out their bows and arrows and to shoot as high as they can, shooting up in the sky, aiming and intending that they are shooting arrows at God if he's really up there. And what Allah did, Allah played a trick, Allah played a joke on them. Allah joke with the unbelievers sometimes. Allah make the arrows return with blood on. And he was happy, saying, see there, we kill God. But this is the rope that Allah gives to the unbelievers. And sometimes to many of us. We do wrong, so Allah give you rope. You continue with your wrongdoing, Allah give you more rope and you pull. And Allah give you more rope and you pull until Allah pulls back. And when Allah pulls back, it's khalas. Finish, it's over. It is this very Nimrud. And listen to this. This man who claimed to be a god, who claimed deity, it is this very Nimrud who married his own mother. By his mother's name was Semiramis. She gave birth to his son who is her son. She gave birth to a son who is also now her grandson. Confusing, eh? This is what the unbelievers are doing. And this is also the origin of the celebration that our people are feasting, the feast of the weekend of Easter. This is where it originates from. It is this very Nimrod that challenged Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam to say, who do you think is your God? So Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam said, my God is Allah. He is the one who created all things. And he is the one who gives death, and he is the one who gives life. So Nimrod said, if that is your God, I can also do that. And he freed two prisoners from jail. They brought the two prisoners in front of Nabi Ibrahim, and the one prisoner he killed, and the other prisoner he pardoned, and said, you can live your life. He said to Nabi Ibrahim, there you see it, I can also give life and death. This is the stupid logic of those who defy Allah. Stupidity, the height of stupidity. But what we can learn from here is that Nabi Ibrahim didn't go into unnecessary arguments with him. Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam brought forward an argument which he couldn't match. And Nabi Ibrahim said to him, my Lord Allah is the one who raised the sun from the east and sets the sun in the west. If you claim to be a God, then raise the sun from the west and let it set in the east. Allah says, فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرَ. And this unbeliever, Nimrod, he was astonished, he was perplexed, and he was intellectually destroyed, because no one has the power to let the sun rise and the sun set. And here Allah teaches us how to argue, how to debate, how to have dialogue with beautiful preaching and reason with them in ways that are gracious and best. This is how we have dialogue. And finally, this Nimrod is the very person, when he gathered his mighty army, they met on a battlefield, and he looked up into the sky, and he said, if there is really a Allah, come down and fight me and my army. Look at the audacity. Look at the temerity. Challenging Allah. And here Allah teaches us never to challenge Allah. Never to mock Allah. Never to take Allah for a joke. Because when he said, where are you if you really exist? Come and fight me. Allah didn't come. Allah sent one of his tiniest creatures. Who do you think? The mosquitoes. On one occasion when Allah protected the Kaaba, Allah sent little birds against Abraha, and the birds destroyed that entire army with its elephant. In this incident against Nimrod, Allah sent a swarm of mosquitoes. And then when that mosquitoes came down, zzz, you can imagine a swarm. If one mosquito calls you at night to cover your head with a blanket that the mosquito can't reach you, can you imagine thousands of mosquitoes coming? Zzz, that army started running and fleeing from the battlefield. Nimrod fled the battlefield, and the mosquitoes destroyed his entire army. And while Nimrod was running, and when you run, you become tired, you become uit asem. What do you say for uit asem in English? Not out asem. What? Short of breath. It means out asem. Short of breath. And he was gasping, and while he was gasping, the tiniest mosquito entered his nostrils. And the mosquito went straight to his brain. And Allah caused the mosquito to remain alive inside his head. Now you can imagine the buzz of a mosquito inside your head. And also, the very purpose of the mosquito is to bite and to suck your blood. So inside his head, the mosquito started biting him and sucking blood from his brain. And every time the mosquito bites and sucks, he felt excruciating pain. And the only thing that gave him relief was to knock his head against the wall. Every time he knocked his head, he feels a little relief. After a while, he became tired of knocking his own head, so he entrusted one of his soldiers to take a knopkiri, a baton, and every time he was in pain, then hit him against his head, and he find a little relief. Few minutes after that, again he feel the pain, kabah, on his head. Again he gets a little, every time until they gave him such a hard knock that he fell down dead. The might of the tiny mosquito destroyed a mighty emperor, a mighty king who claimed divinity. He had no power against one of the tiniest insects of the creation of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal. And therefore, this should serve as a warning for these modern tyrants, these modern despots, these modern killers like Benjamin Netanyahu, like Joe Biden, who they now term and call Joe Genocide, and all these world leaders who stand with Israel, killing innocent babies. Nimrud also, when he was told about the birth of Nabi Ibrahim, was going to be cause his destruction, what he did, he gathered all the pregnant women, and whoever gave birth to a baby boy, they killed that baby immediately, hoping to stop the destruction. But Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam's mother, when she felt she's going to give birth, she escaped very secretly into a cave. And she gave birth to Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam in a cave, left him there, and closed the mouth of the cave, and Allah himself took care of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam as a baby. So it should serve as a lesson for all so-called tyrants throughout the history of humanity, that Allah sees your tyranny. Allah sees your injustice and your oppression. And just as this tiny female mosquito has destroyed Nimrud, I won't be surprised if one of the female mujahideen will cause the destruction of Benjamin Netanyahu and all the other tyrants. Ameen. Because the mujahideen, female mujahideen, are also rising now in Gaza and in Palestine, facing the so-called fourth mightiest army in the world, which has proved to be a joke. They are not really as invincible as they claim to be. And Allah, ameen, in this hour of Jummah, we pray to Allah to grant victory to the mujahideen. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. And so people are also, and I want to tell my Muslim brothers and sisters, don't be frustrated and don't feel hurt by these Arab states who have betrayed the cause of Gaza and the cause of the liberation of Palestine and of Aqsa. And therefore I want to straight say to you today, and I hope you spread this message, because recently there has been a call to boycott Hajj and Umrah. Let me say to you in no uncertain terms, Allah says in His glorious book, Al-Quran, وَأَتِمُّ الْحَجَّ وَالْعُمْرَةَ لِلَّهِ, and perform your Hajj and Umrah purely for the sake of Allah. And therefore, because Hajj and Umrah is part of the prescribed ibadah in the glorious Quran, the terminology that you use of boycott is not right. No one can boycott the Hajj or the Umrah because it's ibadah. What you can do, you can defer or push it back the day to a later stage. Defer it to a later stage when you feel situation is okay, then you can go. The Prophet also performed one Umrah and he was obstructed of performing Umrah. And he turned back, he took off his ihram, ordered all his sahaba to take off the ihram, and he said, we are coming back next year. And the following year he walked into Makkah victoriously, winning Makkah over without lifting a sword. There's power in sabr and power in dua. So no one can boycott the Hajj or the Umrah. You can rather defer it or postpone it. And so in conclusion, we pray to Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal that Allah grant us a tawfiq and hidayah. I believe there's talks that Israel has or will resume attacks against Gaza. I hope they make a terrible mistake. I hope that this time the Mujahideen will completely overtake them. And we hope and pray that Allah Himself will divinely intervene and save the people of Gaza and save the land, that they can all return back to their rightful land which was God given to them. May Almighty Allah grant us tawfiq. May Allah grant us understanding. Ameen. Just a few announcements. We have been asked to make dua for deceased Abida Kutbuddin Pangakar. May Allah grant her and all our deceased Jannatul Firdaus. We make dua shifa for Akbar Bondari as well as Mr. Taj Parker of Botswana, who is ill in hospital. And we also would like to remind you that after Jummah outside the masjid, there will be a special collection by the members of Wheel to Heal. They are the 75 cyclists, inshallah, who hope to raise R1 million. They will cycle for 75 kilometers, bearing in mind the 75 years of oppression of the Palestinian people. So when you leave the masjid, Wheel to Heal people will be outside. Please donate generously, inshallah. And also, we would like to salute Father Michael Weeder of the St. George's Cathedral in town. He's a priest and a father, a religious minister of the St. George's Cathedral in town, and currently he's fasting till the 16th of December, praying to God Almighty to grant victory to the Palestinian people. We salute him. We salute him for his stance. The same like the priest went into the mountains and also fasted on behalf of Imam Abdullah Harun before he was murdered in the apartheid jail. Allah is the one who sees and knows, and Allah is the one who accepts all things. We ask that Allah accept this from him for the liberation of Palestine. Ameen. And then on the 16th of December, we are going to have a very, very special Imam Ghazali seminar. It will be a seminar on the 16th of December from 9:30 a.m. to 12:45. It is called the Imam Ghazali seminar, and it will be run by Professor Ibrahim Musa, who is currently residing in the USA, originally from Cape Town. He was known as Maulana Ibrahim Musa. Alhamdulillah, is Maulana Professor Musa, and he will be here to run that seminar on the 16th of December, upstairs in the auditorium here at Masjid al-Quds, inshallah. Someone's ID was found as, what's the name? Rais Armadin, Rais Armadin, your ID can be collected by Haji Faisal Furfrey. Haji Faisal Salih, our Mu'addin, inshallah. And last but not least, Alhamdulillah, we have a brother. He's originally from Burundi. He came to Cape Town some time ago, and in the process, unfortunately, he got in touch with the wrong friends, who he said, I can speak about, who completely misled him. With the result, he came as a Muslim. They took him off from the path of Islam, and he has never found a rest since that day. Only recently, when he decided he's going to come back to Islam, he found peace coming back in his heart. He is here to once again step back into Islam and make all of us witness that he says the Kalima Shahada. Can I call Brother Lutula Rutwe?
Bismillah,
Ar-Rahman,
Ar-Rahman,
Ar-Rahim,
La
Ilaha
Illallah,
Muhammadu
Rasulullah,
Sallallahu
Alaihi
Wasallam.
I bear witness
that there is
only one Allah.
And I'll be witness
that the Prophet Muhammad,
peace be upon him,
is the last,
the true,
and the final prophet
of Allah.
I am once again
a Muslim,
and I return
to Islam
as my deen,
and all the Muslims
as my brothers
and my sisters,
and I accepted
the name
Abbasi
Umar. Takbir. Allahu Akbar walillahi alhamd. I've assured the brother, he mustn't worry. Allah is the most forgiving. Allah has forgiven him. It is Allah who has brought him back to the deen. So it's once again, you start your life over as a brand new born baby, inshallah. Welcome back into the deen. May Allah strengthen you and all of us in Islam. Amen. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Before we have the adhan, may I humbly request everyone to kindly stand, step forward. Wherever you see a space in front of you, that space is rightfully yours. Can I have everyone's cooperation, please? Everyone? Everyone, please. What's it? Please don't put off the lights. Don't disrespect the Imam of the Masjid and overstep the committee. We need this light for the YouTube camera as well. So don't disrespect me by switching off the lights. Shukran.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين وعدل الشرك والمشركين ربي اختم لنا بالخير برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمه الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر الله اكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي يسبح له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة تنجي قائلها من عذاب أليم. وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله حبيب الرحمن الرحيم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله اتقوا الله اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. وقال تعالى إن الله لا يستحي أن يضرب مثلا ما بعوضة فما فوقها فأما الذين آمنوا فيعلمون أنه الحق من ربهم وأما الذين كفروا فيقولون ماذا أراد الله بهذا مثلا يضل به كثيرا ويهدي به كثيرا وما يضل به إلا الفاسقين. وقال تعالى ألم تر إلى الذي حاج إبراهيم في ربه أن آتاه الله الملك إذ قال إبراهيم ربي الذي يحيي ويميت قال أنا أحيي وأميت قال إبراهيم فإن الله يأتي بالشمس من المشرق فأتي بها من المغرب فبهت الذي كفر والله لا يهدي القوم الظالمين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. بارك الله لنا ولكم بالقرآن العظيم ونفعنا بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر رؤوف رحيم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وانم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك واشرف عبادك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد وصحبه وسلم سلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابته اجمعين.
الحمد لله الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما امر والصلاة والسلام على سيد البشر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة للعالمين وقال تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الخلفاء الراشدين ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين، وعن بقية الصحابة والقرابة والتابعين وتابعي التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، وأذل الشرك والمشركين، ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في فلسطين وفي كل مكان يا مولانا يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. استوى السقيم رحمكم الله. We will be performing kunut in the second ركع إن شاء الله. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
كلا إذا دكت الأرض دكا دكا، وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا، وجيء يومئذ بجهنم، يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأنى له الذكرى،
يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي فيومئذ لا يعذب عذابه أحد ولا يوثق وثاقه أحد يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت وكنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت لك الحمد على ما قضيت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم أعد المسجد الأقصى إلى رحاب المسلمين. اللهم أعد المسجد الأقصى إلى رحاب المسلمين. اللهم ارزقنا صلاة في المسجد الأقصى وهو حر عزيز. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام عليكم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر. استغفر الله استغفر الله استغفر الله العظيم التواب الرحيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم ونتوب إليك ونسألك توبة ومغفرة إنه هو التواب الرحيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام، تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. اللهم لا مانع لما أعطيت ولا معطي لما منعت ولا راد لما قضيت ولا ينفع ذا الجد منك الجد. اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا. اللهم من أحيته منا فأحيهم على الإسلام، ومن توفيته منا وفهم على الإيمان. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم واسكنهم الجنة. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وادخلهم الجنة. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وروحهم في الجنة، فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم. يا أيتها النفس المطمئنة ارجعي إلى ربك راضية مرضية، فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي. اللهم اشفي مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. قال الله تعالى: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.